to read this real quick. So this was a message in Discord from Just Call Me Rika. And I've been meaning to talk about this in the past, and I haven't gotten included, but there's a guy named Bao, I don't know how you say his name, that in the past he was included. This was reported on by, I think, the Free Thought Project and some other people, where he apparently, this is that thing you might have seen where the police chief or whoever he was called all these activists into like a press conference and then arrested all of them under this guise that they were going to have a conference. And then it turned out we arrested them for things that people said in their comment section, if you can believe that. It's crazy. This is absolutely crazy. This is the next generation. This is, so right now, hypothetically, somebody saying something aggressive in my comment section, I could be held accountable for, is what this just set a precedent for that. And she said in his jury trial today, which I think was yesterday, he was found guilty of harassment charges by a jury. The sentence is 180 days in jail and $2,000 fine. The harassment charges resulted from people in his live stream chat calling the Tarrant County Courthouse to seek redress of the court. This is important. Channel owners should not be held accountable for their live stream chat or actions, which I agree. I mean, that's as stupid as somebody standing behind CNN with a sign and they're held accountable for it, or somebody commenting in the section of a YouTube comment. And, you know, it's crazy. You have absolutely no control over that, but this is what they're trying to cultivate. It's kind of like the three felonies in the day kind of thing, that they want to create a way that if they simply want to get somebody to go away, they actually can find a legal route to do it and just be like, look, this guy's touching all the right buttons. Let's fucking get him out of here. Right. So just go to his channel and be like, there's a comment from 10 years ago. You're gone. Right. It gives them an avenue to take so that people can't scream censorship. And this is precedent here. That's how our legal system works. There's a precedent set for this being the case. As for the felony charge of retaliation after Bao, after Bao serves his sentence at Tarrant County, he will be sent to Leon Valley to stand trial. The retaliation charge is also live stream related. It's blaming Bao for one of his chatters posting the home address of a public official in the chat stream. This charge has a possible sentence of 2 to 10 years in prison and a $10,000 fine. The only crime Bao committed was that he held a camera and conducted live streams. Last I checked, cameras aren't deadly or illegal. Crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. If you want to see some information about this, join our Discord chat. She has a lot of the information posted in the call to action section. So you can go in there and support her, support him. This is crazy. I mean, this is what we're dealing with today. This is the kind of thing we're dealing with. These people are finding every possible way they can to abuse the legal system to hurt us, to hurt people that are holding them accountable. Because what this guy did would he's one of those guys that would film cops and hold them accountable. God forbid you should be held accountable. As they just go, oh yeah, malfunction on the body cam. Whoops, turned off. He held them accountable. And they don't like that. It's very crazy.